I was in a 3-year relationship, right? And I came out of that relationship, and it was hard because suddenly you have to have sex with someone who's not that person. It's difficult, right? My girlfriend had sex with someone that wasn't me for 3 years, and that's why we broke up. But it's not true. It's a great joke. So it was just difficult, and so I thought, to get over the first sort of hurdle, I'm just gonna have sex with somebody. I'm gonna do it. Someone I don't necessarily sort of, I don't care. Whatever. So I met them online, and she was like, hey, I am half an hour away from your house. I'm gonna come to your house in half an hour. And I was like, sex. Sex. I said that alone 4 times to myself in my house. She didn't arrive half an hour later. She arrived 2.5 hours later, unbelievably hammered. Like, not just like, I'm drunk. She was like, nah! I was like, hey, I did not expect you to be here. I sort of was ready for bed, and I didn't know what to do. She lived really far away, okay? So I was like, I thought the best thing to do in that scenario, I said, well, come in, and I gave her some pajamas, and I told her just go to sleep. Right, yeah, and she went to sleep in my bed. I slept on the floor, right, and yeah, it's nice. And oh my God, he's not a rapist. Lovely. Bad a man. It's disgusting. Now this is the weird part. About 6:30 in the morning, I woke up. There's some commotion. I woke up. I looked over, she was pissing on the carpet next to my bed. Honestly, one of the worst things I've ever seen. She was just like, looking like. And I was like, whoa, what are you doing? And she went,
look away.
I was like, no, privacy is not the issue. Stop it, stop missing. This is the thing, I don't even know where the women can stop. So it's like, man. Men, we can stop. You hold the end of balloons. It's actually really fun. But, like, I don't know whether women can. I'm looking around for a bulldog clip. I don't know what's. And she was ignoring me, so I had nothing to do. So I just had to stand next to her and wait for her. I can't do anything. I can't grab her and pick her up and take her outside like a dog in the movies. She's just there. So I had to wait for her to finish. I was just waiting for her to finish pissing on my floor. Just waiting for footage. And then she finished, and then she just got back into bed. And I was like, no, please don't. Like, I was like, please, you need to help me clear this up. And she was like, I don't know how to. And I said, Google it, please. Her phone had run out of battery, so I had to Google it. So I Googled that. That's in my history of my phone. How do you clean human urine out of carpets? I Googled that. It said bicarbonate of soda and kitchen towels. So, and apparently you use bicarbonate soda for cakes. I didn't know that. So I went down to my ex-girlfriend's. She liked baking cakes. So I went down to the cake and we got some bicarbonate soda. It was a weird thing where I was like spreading it on her piss. And I was like, my ex-girlfriend used to use this for cakes. And then I went back to sleep. We woke up about 3 hours later. And I was like, oh, hey. She was like, hey. And she was like, I pissed on your floor last night. I was like, yeah, you did. And she went, please don't talk about this on stage. Oh. And I said, I won't, Charlotte Fowler. Thanks very much, guys. It's been an absolute pleasure. I've been John Dommett. Bye-bye!